I always like to get back to the community. If they can put a smile on these people's face just to see us here, you know, some of the people said, you know, I couldn't pass this up. I just wanted to come here and spend time with you guys. And, you know, if they can shed a little light on their lives, God bless them. I love to be here with them.
In Memphis, they can still hear Lorenzen Wright's laugh. It's been 3 years, but they remember his kind ways, his easy smile, and of course, the basketball. Wright was more journeyman than superstar, but his game shone plenty through a 13-year NBA career that spanned 5 cities. Wright grew up in Memphis, starred for the university, and even played for the Grizzlies. And then suddenly, he was gone.
Georgetown 911, where's your emergency?
Hello? I'm nothing but gunshots.
We were from the same area. We were both living out our dreams. We both went to the same college. Very fun, loving guy, jokester. Loved to tell jokes, loved to play around. Just would give you the shirt off his back.
And still to this day, I sometimes just still can't believe he's not here because I'm thinking he's gonna call. I still got his number in my phone. It's just not real.
It was July of 2010 when Wright mysteriously disappeared. He had last been seen visiting his 6 children at the home of his ex-wife. When he didn't show up for a family gathering the next day, his mother knew something was wrong.
I kept calling and calling and calling, and he wouldn't answer. And I was like, this is not looking good right now.
She kept calling or whatever and asking me, have I talked to him? And after a minute, you know, I grew suspicious, you know, because that's unlike my brother not to call me back.
I started getting worried, like, well, he's really missing now. Something's wrong.
Police tried to locate Wright for the better part of a week, not realizing a vital clue was sitting on a recording device just a few miles away.
Georgetown 911, where is your emergency? Hello? Hello? Hello?
Nothing but gunshots.
It's believed that Lorenzen Wright made that call to 911 the day he disappeared from the side of this deserted wooded road. But while the road is just inside the Memphis city limits, the cell tower handling the call routed it to Germantown, the next township over. And it took Germantown officials 8 days to refer the tape to the Memphis police.
What do you think would have happened differently if that 911 operator had hung up the phone and they had immediately started going to the site of the call, since they did know where it came from?
They might not could have saved his life, but they could have got some evidence or something. Or they could maybe got somebody leaving the scene. They did nothing. Nothing.
When police finally got the tape, cell tower records quickly led them to the wooded road and to Lorenzen Wright's body. Hundreds gathered at the crime scene as the news reverberated around the NBA.
Lorenzen was a teammate of mine back in Cleveland, and we spent so many days together. You know, to hear that he was killed in his hometown, it was very emotional.
They found his body probably a mile and a half, 2 miles away from my home. And it's a place that I pass by every single day. And for his body to be found over there was unbelievable.
In the long days it had taken police to find Wright, a series of thunderstorms and the boiling heat of the Memphis summer had badly decomposed his body.
A tall basketball player, 260-something. He was just over 50 pounds. I mean, he's basically just a skeleton.
He weighed less than his baby child when they found him. So we couldn't have an open casket. We just had to have pictures up, and that wasn't a goodbye. I couldn't kiss him for the last time.
The focus now shifted to what exactly happened to Lorenzen. Shara Wright, Lorenzen's ex-wife, provided police with an interesting lead. Police say she claimed Lorenzen left her house with drugs and a large amount of money the night of his disappearance. It's a claim Wright's mother and sister meet with great skepticism.
Have you noticed only she mention anything about drugs.
He has never been arrested for drugs. He's had never been affiliated with drugs. Now all of a sudden he come up missing and dead as drugs.
Other theories surfaced. Family and friends told police Lorenzen was broke despite having made a reported $55 million over his NBA career. Perhaps he was killed over a bad debt, some reasoned. Or maybe he was just a victim of Memphis crime.
One of Lorenzen's friends told police it could have been as simple robbery. What do you think of that theory?
Mm-hmm. Nope. Why didn't he take his watch? Why didn't he take his earrings? It's exactly the ones I got on. Why didn't he take that?
Just as it appeared the case was bearing no new leads or information, a sensational story appeared in the local newspaper, a story detailing how Shara Wright was in a legal battle with Lorenzen's family over the proceeds from his estate.
She got $1 million in proceeds from an insurance policy required through the divorce settlement, and within 10 months had blown through $973,000. She bought a house, a very nice house, a Cadillac Escalade, $70,000 in furniture, renovated additions.
What did you think when you heard about how that money got spent?
OMG, oh my God.
$1 million in 1 year? My brother's not here no more. The money ain't coming in like that, so that's unnecessary. Very unnecessary.
Ms. Wright declined to speak with us on camera, and calls to her attorney were not returned. But court filings on her behalf dispute that she has squandered the estate. Meanwhile, the city of Memphis continues to mourn.
Let me make this clear. The Lorenzen Wright case is not a closed case as long as I am mayor of the great city of Memphis, Tennessee.
Do you feel like the city should be doing anything now more aggressively to solve this case?
All leads that have been presented have been pursued and will continue to be pursued. I wish we could do more. Parents aren't supposed to bear children, and Lorenzen was everybody's son.
You want closure, and the city doesn't even have closure. You know, it's one thing to recover the body and find out, you know, that he's been murdered, but to not know the exact circumstances surrounding it, and the person or persons responsible for that not to be brought to justice, it just does not allow you to have that closure.
No one feels that lack of closure more than Wright's mother. And now, she says her quest to find her son's killer has taken on new urgency. She told us she's been diagnosed with ovarian cancer.
How much time do you feel like you have left?
Well, I don't know. I don't want to put a time frame on it, but I'm gonna work on this until I do go. I'm gonna work till the blood start running warm in my body.
My mother has dedicated her life. She has dedicated her life to finding out who murdered her son.
I gotta get this done because I don't know how long, you know, I'm gonna be here. And if, ain't nobody gonna do what I'm doing for you. Nobody. And that's why I'm running every day. Every day I'm running because I don't know.